Hello friends, today I will explain about one of the spectrum communication technique called DSS, Direct Sequence Spectrum Communication. Spectrum is basically used in radio communication systems. Radio communication systems suffer from problems like interference, jamming, multipath propagation and fading, and also lack of secure communication. Interference example is two people talking at the same time, or when one person is talking, other person is talking loudly with intention to disturb the communication. Another one, jammer. The goal of jammer is to disturb the communication of his adversary. The jammer has a priori knowledge of most communication system parameters, for example frequency bands. Multipath distortion. Multipath refers to more than one path from transmitter to receiver. This multipath may be due to reflections from ground, buildings and other objects like trees, etc. The fading is also one of the disadvantages of radio communication system. It is the fluctuations in received signal amplitude and lack of secure communications. Ordinary radio transmissions are easy to intercept by unwanted listeners. The use of spectrum solves the radio transmission problems listed in previous slide. The term spectrum refers to the expansion of input signal bandwidth. Baseband signal bandwidth is intentionally spread over a large bandwidth. This spreading is accomplished by means of spreading signal called PN sequence. Basic types of spectrum communication systems are direct sequence spectrum and FHSS, frequency hopping spectrum. Block diagram of DSS communication system is shown here. Note that in spectrum communication system, the input data signal is modulated two times. Here, in the transmitter section of a DSS communication system, already modulated signal is given as input to XOR gate. So this is a type of second modulation. The PN sequence is combined with the already modulated signal, for example BPSK signal, and the output is fed to the transmitting antenna. Here, this transmitting antenna and the free space antenna is used to transmit and receive radio signals. So, antenna is a interface between the transmitter and free space. Receiving antenna is used to receive radio signals. Here the second time modulated signal is a wideband DSS signal. Note that the effect of modulation increases the bandwidth of the signal. Here narrowband signal is converted to wideband signal by combining with the PN sequence. PN sequence is also called chipping code. The reverse process takes place at the receiving end of a communication system. DTPLS is the widely used technology for spectrum communications. Here PN sequence, which is pseudo noise sequence is used to modulate already modulated signal. Pseudo means semi-random, because the PN sequence used in spectrum is repeated for number of bits. Note the transmitted signal bandwidth is much greater than information signal bandwidth. XR technique is used to combine data stream with PN sequence. PN sequence is also known as spreading code. PN codes produced by the transmitter are already known to the receiver. At the receiver, despreading is done. The receiver can use the same PN sequence to reconstruct the information signal. Received signal is correlated with PN sequence to recover the data and reject interference. Example of direct sequence spectrum communication is shown here. This is the input stream A. The information to be transmitted is 01001011. For bit 0, we use PN sequence 0110. For bit 1, we use the complement of this PN sequence. Complement of 0 is 1, complement of 1 is 0, complement of 1 is 0, and complement of 0 is 1, and so on. So the transmitted signal, that is DSSS signal, is the exclusive OR of signal A and B. The operation of the XR function is shown here. If both inputs to the function is same, then the output is 0. If the inputs are opposite, then output of the XR function is 1. The operation of the XR function. So here both the bits are 0. So the transmitted signal is 0. For 1 and 0, as the bits are different, it is 1. Again 1 and 0, the output of XR gate is 1. And both the inputs are same, here 0, 0, the output of XR gate is 0. Like that, we can reproduce the other sequence. At the receiving end, the received signal is same as C. As we already noted, the same PN sequence we use at the receiver to reconstruct the original signal. So the PN sequence here at the transmitter and receiver will be same. To decode the received signal, we use XR function between C and B. This is the C exclusive OR B. By applying this XR rules, we get the following table. Finally, because this is the consecutive 4 zeros, we get the received bit as 1, and consecutive 4 ones are decoded as 1, and so on. The waveforms for DSS communication is shown here. This is the input data signal and this is the PN sequence, and the transmitted signal is the exclusive OR of the input data signal and the PN sequence. Here for 1 bit we are using PN sequence of length 4 bit. In practical cases we use more number of chips. These are called chips. The PN sequence bits are called chips. We use 128 for example, because the security of information depends on the length of the PN sequence also. It affects the security of transmitted information. So at the receiving end, we apply again the previous table rules to reproduce the transmitted signal, to reconstruct the transmitted signal. Here I will explain effect of PN sequence on transmitted spectrum. This is the data signal we are going to transmit, having bit duration of TB, and this is the PN sequence having chip duration of TC. The bandwidth of the spectrum heavily depends on the duration of the pulse. So here I will explain Fourier transform to convert time domain signal to frequency domain signal. So these are time domain signals having different pulse width. If you take the Fourier transform of this pulse, you will get a sinc function. Sinc function is the sin x by x function. So if you compare the bandwidth of the PN signal and transmitted signal, this is the narrow band signal. The data signal, if you convert into time frequency domain, it will give you narrow band signal. The Fourier transform of PN sequence will give the wide band signal. So note that some signals are easy to study in time domain and some signals are easy to study in frequency domain. Remember that a signal complex in time domain will be easy to study in frequency domain and vice versa. Suppose sine signal is complex in time domain. If you take Fourier transform of sine signal, we get simply two spikes in frequency domain. So this complex signal can be easily studied in frequency domain. Various applications of DTPLS and its disadvantages are given here. Please go through it. Thank you very much.